Welcome to my channel, guys. So in this video, we're talking about Extra, a British science fiction horror movie that came out back in 1982. And this movie traumatized me as a kid. One scene in that movie traumatized me as a kid, and I didn't realize that until this very moment. I don't know if you guys ever experience like watching something in childhood that really freaked you out, and the memory of that scene in a movie that freaked you out kind of followed you your whole life, but you could never place exactly where that came from. Well, I had the experience like that with this movie. Apparently, I have seen a certain infamous scene from this movie back when I was really, really small. Can't even remember how old I was, but I was small and I didn't know what the hell was going on, but it freaked me the hell out. And I don't know if I have seen the whole movie or if it was just that one scene I stumbled across when I was watching TV unsupervised or something. But my whole life I remembered this particular scene from this movie, but I didn't know where it came from. So I was actually kind of convinced that it was like a fever dream or a figment of my imagination or something. So today I decided to randomly watch this movie that I stumbled across on a free movie site that I was browsing. And lo and behold, as I'm watching the movie, out of nowhere comes the scene that traumatized me as a kid. So I'm like, damn, so that shit was actually real this whole time. Okay, so I wasn't crazy. That's nice to know. Anyways, so in this movie, a family man disappears one day, leaving behind his wife and young son. The wife believes that the man has abandoned the family, while the son believes that his father was taken in by aliens and that he would one day return. 3 years later, the man does return, claiming that he has no recollection of what's been going on with him for the past 3 years. Where has he been? Any of that. And he seems very determined to reconcile with his family, especially he is concerned with reconciling with his young son, with whom they very easily bond because the young boy never believed that his dad abandoned him. He always knew he would come back. Seems like it's a happy family reconciliation there for a minute, until we realize that something is actually pretty wrong with this man. And that he's influencing his son in a pretty sinister and messed up ways. This movie is pretty damn low budget, and it definitely shows. It's very cheesy at times, but at other times it's also pretty gory and pretty gross. Like, it's one of those movies that is just, like, certain scenes in there are just really nasty and gross to look at. There are certain body horror elements in this movie that are definitely not for the squeamish. It's not a pleasant movie to look at ever, to be honest. Like, there's something really nasty about it. But I actually enjoyed the movie because at the same time it was kind of interesting, and it had a really weird and creepy atmosphere throughout that I really liked. There was something really unsettling about it. It's definitely a very, very weird movie. It's one of those movies that you watch and after you watched it you say to yourself, what the fuck did I just watch? It's not as gross though as I thought it was gonna be, especially from that certain scene happening pretty early on in the movie, which traumatized me back in childhood, which involves a woman giving birth, if you can even call it that. And there's actually a pretty similar scene to that in a Japanese movie called Gozu. That scene freaked me out as well, but nowhere near the scene in Extra, presumably because I was a small child when I first seen it and had no business looking at something like that. The acting in this movie is okay, like, it's definitely not the best. I would say it's a pretty typical B-movie type of acting. And the characters, of course, could have been developed better. The storyline itself was interesting to me to watch. I do feel like the pacing was a little bit uneven in this movie. I do feel like it had like a pretty interesting opening, and then the movie kind of slowed down for the middle part, and then it picks back up closer to the ending. And as far as like those nasty, gory scenes are concerned, The first, like, really nasty scene is very close to the beginning of the movie. There's, like, a break in that for a while, and then the stuff comes back with a vengeance. I don't think they used any CG for this movie, practical effects only, and some of those practical effects probably did not age too well in our time. Like, whenever they show those alien creatures, it's always pretty damn clear that it's a puppet. Like, it doesn't look realistic in any way, shape, or form. But, you know, once again, the movie came out back in, like, 1982, and probably back in those days, those puppets looked pretty damn convincing. And a lot of movie critics hated this movie. Like, the famous movie critic Robert Ebert called this movie, I believe, ugly and despairing or something like that. And a lot of other movie critics also hated this movie, called it trash and all kind of names. But interestingly enough, it actually achieved cult status since its release. It's one of those movies that I think that most actual movie critics hate, but it was a lot more favorably released by the audience. At times in this movie, it does seem like they were just trying to make it as gross as possible and maybe put certain scenes in there for shock value. And in a way, it was kind of like a train wreck too, and I couldn't stop watching it. The main attractions in this movie, I feel like the atmosphere and the visuals and some of the practical effects. There was definitely something very surreal about this film. So I would rate this a 6 out of 10. Thank you guys for watching. Like this video if you enjoy my review, subscribe to my channel, all that good stuff, and I'll see you in the next video. Okay, bye.